Welcome to Spooky Stories. Tonight, I'm sharing with you an old-fashioned porch tale about a strange neighborhood. It's called Those Most Trusted. There's a road not far out of town, beyond the first high ridge to the east. It used to be longer. Used to run further in both directions, but it's been cut short since the ends sold and parceled. Each part has a different name, and the long middle stretch is named for a place that isn't there anymore, a schoolhouse. It was called something else before that. Sometimes, when someone is trying to remember the name of that street, they think of the old name, because it makes sense. It's more of a country lane than a road. It's the lane with the ridge view. Ridgeview Lane. After a while though, no one wanted to live on Ridgeview Lane anymore. It was easier to name it something else. It wasn't just one thing that happened. There was a certain kind of thing that happened a lot of different ways. It involved the ones they most trusted. And it was never the same, but it was like that. What could have happened over the years? And where would those records be? Something like that happened recently. No one saw it coming. There are cold spots around, hanging mists along the road. A shiver might settle into someone dear, an unnatural turn of the head. Love can withstand these forces, but everyone grows weak at times. Teachers and their students, children and their parents, farmers and their animals, siblings, spouses, hosts and visitors. Best friends, refugees and their protectors, honor among thieves, soldiers' code, the welcoming and the welcomed, families and caretakers, lovers. These are all bonds that stand the test of time, that grow in importance, that can be hard to live without. They can last until the end, the very end, the bitter end. They didn't finish building that house, and now it just stands there, the second story it gave. The well surrounds itself with ditches. A sagging shed roof is draped with tatters. I shouldn't really talk about a father of two young children who people didn't believe really killed himself after the night he argued with his brother. The guy living in his car offered refuge for watching a dog. He let the dog out and came to harass her. There used to be a trail that people used to walk into town from the middle of the ridge. Now it's laying under a sinkhole pond on a property that two brothers fought over. There are so many reasons why people stay. There are a lot of great things about this spot. In the pond at the one end, there are leeches and sharp edges. Someone moved in who started firing their automatic rifle into it. There's a deep rutted road that's overgrown leading to an empty back lot. Buzzards watch the place. There's that spot right at the top of the hill where something died and laid there until it rotted away completely. And the mossy earth was blackened around the remaining pile of bones. Right next to where people have been living, that's the spot they gave to me. When they moved me out for a new tenant who worked for them, I scattered those bones so they wouldn't think that was my doing or lack thereof. I don't know why I didn't do it sooner. Poison hemlock grows there too. Sometimes it is very, very quiet. A conversation can cross the entire valley. Other times, sound swirls over from the road and the neighbors from surprising directions. There are so many great things about it. Singing frogs, morning light, rare flowers, wild berries, perhaps even enough wood, though not. It's dotted with boulder outcroppings, the one by the pond that's sporting a rusted chain, one at the entry corner of the driveway, one at the exit corner of the smaller driveway across from the well ditches. One must always drive carefully. One in the fork of the turnaround, one to the side of the overgrown road, and another on the other side, only noticeable if you're leaving from the other direction. This is the last place on the right, or the first place on the left up the hill. There are a lot of remnants around. The view across the valley is crystal clear. It's a long walk to town, but not too long of a walk. Down where the road winds to the bottom of the hill, vehicles end up in that tricky ditch. I've seen one myself end up. That hill is terrible when it's icy. Good thing you can come in from the other side of the road. A neighbor who was transitioning between medications said he saw people come up to his house who didn't show up on camera. Especially remarkable were the two ladies coming up to his window with a tray of sunglasses, offering him a pair. Why do some things end up going so badly? People can act in ways you never expect of them. Some problems don't display themselves properly. Things are a bit sideways already. Boundaries dissolve differently. Things become possible that weren't. Some things seem impossible when they really aren't. This road's been renamed, chopped up, records could have been destroyed, who knows? It wouldn't be the first time, nor the last.